The opinions of the individuals during this broadcast are their own and may not be the opinions of their group or other organizations they may be involved with.
We are people advocating cannabis education here at PaceRadio.net.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Pace Radio on the Road, OTR. We are live here down in Tioga at Legacy 420 for the Pass the Peace Pipe announcement. Things will be get going here very shortly. We'll be able to see what's going on, learn all the information. They're going to be doing some fundraising later today in Belleville. But right now, we're going to learn all about what's happening. And for those who are here, we've got a few other things. We've got some samples. And I've got some things where I've learned, such as turning the camera around so we can see what's going on here. Just getting ready here, guys. Doing some testing. As you can see, we're here at Legacy 420. See the big sign over here. Legacy 420 Medical Cannabis Dispensary. Cannabis testing facility as well. Don't forget, you can get your cannabis tested here. And NIMCA, which is the National Indigenous Medicinal Cannabis Association, is here as well. There we go. As I learn this stuff, we're getting there. Getting there. They're just sort of laying out how things are going to go. I just didn't want to get ahead of them. That's all. As they plan things here. Said there's free samples here today too. Some drink samples. 10-10. Juice samples. Some shatter candy. Some mango juice. Okay. I think they're getting ready here. Turn my camera back around for you. See, got some video going on here. They're getting some things recorded. Yeah, let's go back to those samples. Take a look at things here.
So how you been, Al?
Good. Doing well. Trying to stay out of the hospital. There we go. It's free samples of some CBD mango juice. We got some free samples of some blueberry shatter candy and peanut brittle. Looks good. There's that blueberry shatter.
Yeah. Do you want Earl Grey or Orange Pekoe? Do you take milk or sugar?
We got some mango juice. I guess that's the same as the other one down there. Yeah. And here's some information on today. Bring that in for you. Mm-hmm. So you can see that.
And then we've got spoons for sugar and we've got spoons.
Well, that's why 1017 is the new harvest. More important, right?
Just waiting to get started here, folks.
So maybe at 10:16, I'll start talking, and then just give me a wink when it's exactly 10:17. Hey, it's 10:17. Yeah.
We're planning.
Yeah.
And for those that find it a little bit chilly out here today, got ourselves coffee, some tea. Is there teas in here? Look at that. There we go. I was right. Hey. Oh, we got some Earl Grey tea too. Keep things warm. Goes Kathy. Yeah, let me check the time. Get another minute or two here before they get going on everything. So just hold on with me here, folks. Yeah, go for a bit of a walk. Once again, Legacy 420, medicinal cannabis dispensary, cannabis testing facility as well. They've got a full-size lab here. NIMCA, National Indigenous Medicinal Cannabis Association, is out of here. Sorry for the ground shot, people. They happen. Oh, someone's alarm is ringing. Gonna run up there.
Yeah.
Getting a warm drink before we get started.
What time is it now?
Tell me when you're going, don't you? Once you're
go.
Gotta get a picture of the
act. Yeah.
So I can post that later. Yeah, getting things ready. Another minute here. Tim's getting his coffee.
I'm a rattle and roller.
It's getting warm.
I don't shake, I rattle and roll.
Yeah, it is cool here.
Oh boy.
Oh, we just got the notice.
I'm scared.
Okay, everything is rolling.
All right. Test 1, 2. We're here at Legacy 420 for a special day.
Yes, it is. Special day.
No problem.
Okay.
Then, there we go.
Okay, so let's get this. Are we at 10:16 yet?
10:16.
Okay, perfect. Okay, so let's tell me when you're rolling and we'll just.
I'm rolling.
Okay. In three.
This is the important one.
Hi, folks. I'm Scott Granville from stfatty.com, and I'm absolutely proud to be here at C420 with my good buddy Tim Barnhart. This is an amazing time of year. It's harvest time, but it's also St. Fatty's Day. 10:17, it's the new 420, and we are here to pass the peace pipe, and it is at 10:17 exactly. So let's do this. This is the ceremonial pass to my good friend Tim.
Thank you very much.
We did this specifically on this date because this is Cannabis Legalization Day on October 17th, and we wanted to partner with the most important Indigenous growers of cannabis in Canada. Cannabis has always been very important to me for medicinal use with my family, with myself, and we knew that Legacy 420 is the leader in Canada, and we wanted to start a program that's going to help people here in First Nations, specifically Mohawk territory, and our program is called Pass the Peace Pipe, and we trying to gather funds for holistic healing centers. And Tim, maybe you can talk a little bit about that.
I sure can. So it's well overdue. I think drug addiction in First Nations is really an unfortunate situation. And I think it's high time that we stepped up to the plate and, you know, started contributing to the infrastructure of the building so that we can begin the process of healing our people.
Tell us how that's going to start. Tell us about the land.
So I'm donating some land, up to 5 acres if we need to be. And that is going to, you know, start this whole process and going. So I'm donating land in value of $100,000. So that's a pretty good start to the campaign, I would say.
Absolutely. And this is a call to action for everybody coast to coast. We are going to be doing a video to help pass the peace pipe and get the awareness out, but we also need skilled trades.
Right.
We need people to come together. This is going to be a community build that we start one build at a time, starting here, thanks to your generosity. But we want this to be a coast-to-coast thing, and we're starting slow, but this is how the momentum starts on St. Paddy's Day.
Absolutely. So coast-to-coast-to-coast, actually. So even in the south. So we'll take donations from the United States, all points, actually. We need to build at least 5,000 square foot building, and that's going to require a lot of capital and a lot of manpower. So all parts around the globe, this is where it's happening, right here in Pennsylvania.
Absolutely. And go to our GoFundMe page, because contribute.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And tell us a little bit about why you think the medicinal angle of cannabis is so
great
important.
Question. So it's healing property. So I myself became addicted to opiates earlier in my life through an operation I had to repair my hip, and I became addicted to pills, and I'm not proud of that, but I'm one of those statistics. And so it was a long time. It was a long battle for me to find my way, and cannabis was a vehicle that I rode in to save life. And I think a lot of our people will be able to use that same vehicle to heal themselves.
Absolutely. Cannabis is a healing plant, isn't it?
Yes, it certainly is. And that's how we look at it here at Legacy 420. Absolutely, yep. Is a healing plant.
And that's why you guys are the leaders in cannabis, medicinal cannabis.
I think that has a lot to do with it, is in how we look at this plant. So it's a fun plant to a lot of people, but to us it's a very serious plant.
And you, a lot of your clientele are seniors, and really seeing that seniors are seeing this as an alternative method.
They absolutely are. So that's another great question. Between 50-70% of our people that come here for medicine are in that age group. So it's an older demographic, and they are healing using this product. And we would just love to broaden our scope and put it on every First Nation across this country. Absolutely. Start the healing process.
Absolutely. Well, listen, is there anything else that you wanted to add?
Just contribute to any way you can. Go to our GoFundMe site and donate. Yes.
And pass the peace pipe.
And pass this peace pipe.
I'll take that. Yeah. Thanks
very much. Copy up.
Thanks very much for hanging up. We really appreciate everybody coming. And pass the peace pipe and happy St. Paddy's Day to everybody. You want to have a say, Kathy?
Sure.
Here comes Kathy.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Kathy O'Coyne, and I'm the Director of Quality and HR here at Legacy 420. Thank you all very much for coming out today to join us on the launch of our Pass the Peace Pipe project. This will conclude our press conference, and we will be having a networking session starting at 1 o'clock at the Foster Ward Community Center, which is at 75 St. Paul Street in Balboa. And we're gonna have some raffles, there will be some lunch, and we'll also be sharing some more information on the Pass the Peace Pipe project. So we hope that you can all join us. For those of you that can't, please follow the Pass the Peace Pipe project on Instagram. and thank you very much.
Bonne.
Thank you. That's it.
All right.
Thanks, good. Guys.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks, everybody.
Guys.
You're welcome.
Thank you, guys.
Yeah, that's me. That's neat, eh?
Hi.
There we are.
Thanks, everybody.
She's all over. Press conference, so everybody can learn about that as far as past the peace pipe and what it's all about when it comes to helping indigenous communities to deal with opiate addiction. As Tim said, he himself was addicted to opiates due to an injury that hip surgery. So, you know, use cannabis to get off, get away from them. And, oh, look at that. Look who's here. I'm just going to see if I can. See if I can steal. You could probably hear the voice in the background.
Best friends forever.
Look who's here.
Hi.
How you doing?
This was too important not to miss.
Oh, glad you made it. I'm glad.
What an important thing for them to be taking this on.
Oh,
and
big
to be
time.
Doing this.
Big time.
Someone needed to take the initiative and spread this apart. And this is
the best
place
to
do
it.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I completely agree.
Hello to everybody.
All right.
Hello. We'll see you soon.
See you soon. There you go. I didn't know. Reverend Kelly was coming out here today, so it was good to see her here. It was a bit of a surprise. I'm going to see if I can get a few words with the man here who's dealing with all this. See if I can steal him for a minute or two. He's just talking to somebody. This is Scott. Scott Granville. He was a guest on the Pace Radio Show on Wednesday. Oh, let's see if I can steal Kenzie here. Hey.
Hi.
Hey, we're live, Kenzie. How
Hi,
you
guys.
Doing? How you doing?
Good.
Everything went well. We got it all
oh
off
gosh.
Before the rain started.
Yeah, it's just about to come down.
I
Everything's
agree.
Gone really, really well. I'm so excited about this project.
Yes, exactly. As Kelly says, Reverend Kelly was just, I was just talking to her, you know, this is a place to start. This is big.
Yeah.
And
it's a powerful movement that's starting.
Correct,
yeah.
Correct.
And Legacy 420 is the place to start it.
Yeah, because there are so many people who are suffering from opioids.
Absolutely.
And you know,
yeah.
My own story is that I knew those years to give it I had a choice.
Yeah.
And when people know that they have a choice, then they can make it.
Yeah.
And
you'll
choose cannabis over opiates.
Absolutely. It's long overdue. A project like this is long overdue,
exactly.
And now's the time.
Yes.
We're just absolutely thrilled. Support as much as you can, guys. Follow our Instagram at Pass the Peace Pipe Project.
Mm-hmm.
Just get involved.
And where's the thing again this afternoon?
So the event is happening at the Foster Ward Community Center in Belleville. That's 75 St. Paul Street.
Mm-hmm.
That's going to be from 1 to 4 p.m. today.
Yep.
There is delicious food donated by the Unnamed Food Truck. Shout out.
No problem.
And there is loads of raffle prizes. There's 50-50 draw. There's toonie toss. There's loads of really good stuff that can be brought home. It's going to be a good time, guys. It's just a great way to kind of network and find people that want to be involved and want to help in such a great project.
Yeah. Super.
Yeah.
Super. Thank
thanks
you.
So much.
You're welcome. We'll talk to you soon.
See ya.
See ya. Bye-bye. Go.
You're listening to the Pace Radio Network here at paceradio.net.
At Legacy 420, we believe in being different.
Experience the difference of quality control.
Our labs provide tested formulations for all of...
Oh, there you go. You just never know what's going to happen. Sometimes you hit the wrong button. Oh, touchful screens. They do that to us. All right. Can I get a few words with you?
Of course. Absolutely.
Just bring you over here. All right. Okay. G'day, here I am here now with the man himself, Scott Granville of St. Fatty's Day.
There you go.
Yeah, guest on the Pace Radio Show past Wednesday. It's good to meet you in person.
Yeah, finally we meet face to face.
That's right. And the fact that you're doing something here that is so needed.
Yes, passing the peace pipe. It was a ceremony today, but it's a call to action to help opioid addiction.
specifically on First Nations land. So Tim Barnhart from Legacy 420. Wow, generosity.
Woo. Yeah, I see five acres.
5 acres. We're going to start to build the first holistic healing center, starting one build at a time. So we're really, it's amazing that we were able to launch the campaign on St. Fatty's Day, right at 2017.
So. Yes, exactly. And St. Fatty's Day is based on?
It's the date of legalized cannabis in Canada. On October 17th, it happened to land there. So I ended up trademarking the idea of having St. Fatty's Day. And we really wanted to do something significant for the medicinal part, because it's really changed my life. So we wanted to make sure that, it's fun. St. Fatty's, that's a fun name and whatnot. But we wanted to do something significant, and helping out opioid addiction on First Nations is the best thing that we can do.
Exactly. I see one of our hosts here on the network send a message. Is happy legalization day from Samara.
Yeah. That's great, eh?
So that come up on the screen. Let's see what else. Probably an odd twist of the story is this morning, Scott and I found out we have a mutual friend.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah. We went, what? You know so-and-so. It worked out, it's a small world, and it just shows people can connect, and you can connect through things like this Peace Pipe Initiative.
Absolutely.
Oh, there it is.
There's
right
the
there.
Pipe. There's the actual pipe I got from Legacy, and this is the pipe that started the dream, and it's amazing that Tim's been generous enough to donate some land. It's a call to action for people that have skilled trades. It's going to be a great community build, and using October 17th, St. Fatty's Day as the day every year to come back and go, what did we do in a year?
Yeah.
What did we do?
What did you achieve?
What did we achieve, and what can we do in the future? So
correct.
It's a call to action, but it's also a date that we have to make sure that it's something that we make sure that we're continuing to get bigger and better every time.
Yes,
and it's a good date to have.
And as success builds and things get bigger, people will see that and see the difference.
Yeah,
and more people even jump on board.
For sure.
Yeah.
It's definitely a momentum thing.
Yeah.
The more people talk about it, the more people realize that St. Fatty's Day is the new 420, then they will realize. And if we can make this as the date that we know the call to action, we know what we've done in 1 year, and it's a measurement for us.
Yeah.
So that next year in 2022, on October 17th, St. Fatty's Day, we're going to be updating everybody where we are in the build, where we are in the second and third and fourth build, because it's really important.
Excellent.
It's not just about one. It's about doing it coast to coast.
Yeah.
We can't just have one. Tim's going to be the guy, Tim Barnhart. He's the guy that's going to be showcasing how to do it, and everyone else is going to be jumping on board.
And the healing centers, you're going to be having counselors?
Counselors. Yes, their approach to healing on First Nations is different than what you would have traditionally. The big issue with opioid addiction treatment is there's so few actual places to go. So if you have an issue with opioid addiction, the chances are that you're going to have to move somewhere else to get treatment.
That's
you literally
right.
have to go someplace else and leave your location,
yeah.
which is terrible for the person. And it's also extremely expensive, $30,000 a month.
Yeah, There was actually an article that I shared with some of the hosts here on the network. We're talking about in Northern Ontario and having that situation where there's nowhere for people to go.
Right.
And people having to be moved hundreds of miles away from the family in order to receive treatment.
It's crazy because that costs so much money for relocation. And plus, every doctor knows that relocation outside your family is not going to work.
No.
You need the support of the people around.
Correct.
And that's why, if we can do it one build at a time, let's see what happens. And then
and
this is a call, literally a call to action that we have a date now, October 17th every year. And if we come back next year without significant progress, we really have to look at it. And we need funding from the government. We need funding, private funding, and we need support from people, again, the skilled trades, builders, electricians, plumbers that can help.
Yeah.
It doesn't really take that long to put up a building. It just takes a lot of support.
A lot of support, yeah. You can see some of the programming on televisions where homes go up in support in very quick time. 3 months, they're up.
Right.
Real fast. Yep. Everybody, the community gets together.
For sure.
People support each other.
Yeah.
And you get the job done.
and we've up to this point, this is a program that just started, and we're getting a lot of support. We're hoping to get on Hometown Hockey October 30th. That's a big one in Belleville, and we hope that Tim will be on to showcase what he's doing to help. So that's we're really pushing for that and getting as much publicity as possible.
Yeah, that's what you need, publicity. Yep. Get the word out, spread the word, share this video so people can see the announcement. All right. Well, thanks a lot, Scott.
Thanks.
And it was good meeting you in person.
Yes, for sure, Al. That was awesome.
And we'll be talking to you.
For sure.
All right.
Thanks,
thank
Al.
You. Bye-bye. All right. There you go. Live here from Legacy 420 with their, oops, just dropped the spare phone. We don't need to be doing that, do we? All right. Well, that's about it for now. Everybody's gone inside where it's warmer. And we're just getting a little bit of rain here. So I think I'm going to split as well. And other than that, check out the GoFundMe page. Check out Pass the Peace Pipe on Instagram. Get involved. Opiate addiction is nasty. And we need to deal with that. So until the next time that we go live, we'll see you then. Bye-bye.
I'm on the road again.
The opinions of the individuals during this broadcast are their own and may not be the opinions of their group or other organizations they may be involved with.
You're listening to the Pace Radio Network here at paceradio.net. You're listening to the Pace Radio Network here at paceradio.net.
BMA Hydroponics has everything you need to succeed. Visit our hydroponics superstore at 404 Maitland Drive in Belleville, and we'll show you how to grow your own quality cannabis for pennies per gram. We're open Mondays, Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and Saturdays from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m., and Thursdays and Fridays from 10 a.m. to 7 p.m. Call 613-967-9888. BMA Hydroponics, it's worth the drive.
The only way.
CTCP operates a medicinal cannabis signing clinic. If you want to grow your own medicinal cannabis and are located anywhere in Canada, then I'd like to suggest that you give them a call. They can be reached at 1-613-967-9888. That's 1-613-967-9888. And grow on with CTCP.
Are you interested in Canadian and international cannabis news? If you are, then catch myself, Kim Cooper, and Al Graham for our live reefer report on the Pace Radio Network, found at paceradio.net.
A doctor's job is to relieve your pains. And when it comes to growing cannabis, the biggest pain is trimming. Let Dr. Buck Cannabis Trimming Solutions take the pain away. Whether you're a home grower or a commercial operation, we have the cure. From 4 plants to 400 plants, garden size doesn't matter. Dr. Buck Cannabis Trimming Solutions comes to you with years of experience and professional discreet service. It's simple. We trim your weed and we do a damn good job. Visit drbuckcts.com to book your trimming.
Enjoy the buzz of legalization with Campbellford Lifestyle Shop. From lights to plant nutrients, books, consumption accessories, and more, we've got all your basics to grow or consume cannabis. Visit our info center or take a look at our piercing services and body jewelry, now available in-store through Campbellford Lifestyle Shop, 17 Bridge Street West, Campbellford.
The People's Alliance of Cannabis in Canada is an organization working to improve cannabis legalization in Canada. They have a mission and values that includes all Canadians, no matter where they come from. The values are including everyone, as no one should be excluded from participating, equality, diversity, advocacy, along with cannabis education and research, plus industry safety and professional standards. If this is an organization that has the same values as you, check them out at peoplesallianceofcannabisincanada.ca. Once again, peoplesallianceofcannabisincanada.ca. Check them out.
At Legacy 420, we believe in being different.
Experience the difference of quality control.
Our labs provide tested formulations for all of our products.
Experience the difference in trust.
Our customers can trust that we are following up-to-date COVID precautions for their safety.
Experience the difference in accessibility.
We're open 7 days a week. Please visit our website, legacy420.com, or contact us for curbside pickup as well as nationwide mail order shipping.
Legacy 420 values overall wellness.
Come and experience the difference of Legacy 420.
You're listening to the Pace Radio Network here at paceradio.net.
You're going to have to get one of these days. Yeah. This is Yeah, St. Fatty's Day.
Yeah, and we're doing a TV series called The Unreal Hashwise of Canada.
Oh, yeah, really?
Is that rain?
This is my brand, KGL Network. We do have we have a media brand as part of what we do, and I'm part of Pace Radio. Okay. So let's connect. I'd love to know a little bit more. It's absolutely nice to meet you.
KGL TV.
Thank you.
All right, Lewis. There you go. All done.
Right on.
And discussing things with people. So we're on our way, people. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.